Okay, so in the previous video, just kind of working with the basic timing without doing any of the rolling, went back and tweaked a little bit of that. Let's select our little translate thing. Controller, right? So I've done just a little thing. So you know, I'm using linear keys, and that's working pretty well as far as the forward motion, is it's as a basic speed forward between each bounce, right? But the last part here is going to be a roll. Right? So this key here is going to be linear, but this one I've made flat because it's going to roll kind of to that end. And I shortened the distance a little bit based on that. I also went and added just a little bounce. I had four bounces before, and I did just a little hop right there. Of course, it looks weird because it's not rolling, right? So let's talk about some strategies how to approach that. So I think this timing is going to be too quick on this. My idea is that it would come up and wait for a second and then maybe roll back real quickly and then launch itself forward. We'll see. I might want to add a few more frames there, right? So I've keyframed all that motion. I've also started to, the trick here, let's do, let's bring this up. So as the animation rolls back, actually, I went through and tried to smooth these curves out a little bit. The trick is, where does it need to be smooth and where does it need to move at a constant rate? So here, you know, it stays in the Z and then it starts to roll back, but it's not a bounce, right? So it should ease out of that position and then it slows back to moving forward, and this is where I think probably needs to be a little bit longer, but I'll go with it. But then the speed that it comes off here should be a little more smooth, right? That transition and how it rolls off. Right now it starts to slow down and then speeds up again. It's a little tiny thing, but that's just not the way it should be, right? So I'm just gonna go ahead and actually, so those are just going to make that a smooth key, right? So this is the first one I've used that's not a linear key. Right? I'm just going to kind of point that in that direction. So let's see what happens. Right? So it kind of pauses out here. In fact, I just made it maybe just a little too steep. There we go. Right? And then it starts moving forward at basic, pretty close to a constant speed, right? That's a pretty straight line until it hits the bounce, and then it's going to move forward. You know, I just want to add some variation where that speed is happening in the bounces, right? Okay. You know, and the nice thing here is because I didn't put a keyframe in the Y direction, it's just, you know, if I want to make this bounce more or less based on that spacing, it's always going to be correct because I have this distance from here to here. There's no keyframe in the middle for the Z because I know that the motion should peak right here at the top, right? So don't necessarily need a keyframe sometimes to get, we're going to use the graph editor to help us, right? So let's say we wanted this to move forward, right? Right, so it makes this big leap here. Doesn't necessarily look wrong, right? Let's see what happens. Maybe it does look wrong, right? So it has a little bit of a crazy bounce to it, right? That's certainly something that's going on. Let's just go back to where it was a second ago, right? So, but if we want to, we can hopscotch this a little bit because we haven't put a keyframe there, and all we're doing is saying halfway in between these, the Y is going to be up in the air, right? Based on whatever these Z's are. Okay, so that's, as long as we don't slide this and mess with the timing in the Y translate here, right? So you can see I'm right on frame and I can make whatever changes I want to this. So let's just say it maybe bounces maybe a little bit less and then it kicks forward. I don't know. Let's just play that and see what happens. So if you were doing kind of a goofy ball that has that weird weighting, that might work. So I just want to make that point. So let's get back to the roll. Right, so how do I want this to work, and how do I think about where the keyframes need to be smooth and linear and those kind of things. So let's just go right back to the beginning, and I'm going to select the rotate tool. I'm basically just going to rotate this in the one axis, which I'm assuming is going to be the X here, but I'm going to keyframe all three of them in case I, after the fact, want to add a different kind of rotation to it, right? So let's see. We move all the way up here in the Z to frame 30. And I'm just going to make a guess, right? That it rolls forward. And I'm just doing some of this by eye. So this rotation happens in a linear fashion. Let's go back and select the Move tool itself, and we'll go to Z and hit, I'm just going to select this frame here. So you can see this is the beginning and this is the end, right? So this, it appears to match itself pretty well. And there's some tricks we could use to like really nail that, but if it looks right, then it is right, as far as we're concerned. But really, when the character gets to the edge, it shouldn't just move straight there and stop. It should slow down, right? I'm going to make that flat. And actually, at the beginning, I'm going to make that flat. So it should kind of slow and then get to the edge and get a little bit slower, right, as it does this. It kind of looks through there. Nice ease in and out. But you can see now the ball seems to be slipping, right? And this is exactly the thing we do not want to have happen. So just keep this stuff in mind because I've modified that curve to ease in and out. Let's just select the rotate tool and let's go with two flat keys right there, right? So now that rate of change should match pretty well. And you might have to add little keyframes. This is something you're just going to have to look at very closely as this moves along, right? So let's slide through in our animation. It stays there. So I'm going to put a keyframe, right? And then it's going to back up a little bit. So how many frames should that be, right? 1, 2, 3. All right, so right there. Let's do a little rollback. And again, I'm just going to guess. Seems a little much. And of course, the other thing is I've already modified the curve. So if I look at this one here. So if I look at that Z curve, and let's go into the view, normalized view. So the normalized view fits everything between 1 and minus 1, so you can look at kind of the percentage of the curve itself, right? So the Z translate is here, and there's the, right? So there's the X. You can see this one, if I zoom in on it a little bit more, is flat here, you know, and then speeds up and comes out of that. So I need to select both of those. I'm going to make them flat as well. So I get a similar rate of change. But you can see it's, you know, they're not in sync with each other. This is where you're going to have to do some modifications to make sure. You might have to put little, in fact, they're actually off a frame. There we go. So that should help. All right, so we have that curve now working in sync with each other. And then it's going to roll back forward, so that should be about the same distance. So let's just select our rotate. All right, let's zoom out here so I get all three of these. And I'm going to go from my view back to absolute view, so I can just see everything this way. And it's almost like I didn't record the Z. Maybe I forgot that somewhere. Anyways, as I'm moving forward, I want it to come off the thing. So I'm going to time warp this from 45 to 55 is where it seems to come off. And here, actually, this curve would be speeding up. This is what I did with the other one, right? All right, so let's just look at this. I guess we can keep it right here. Right? Right? So it just does a little, but it seems to be working pretty good. There's a little, see that little slide right there? Those are the things I want to be conscious of, and I might have to put little keyframes in there to keep it from moving. Right? So this maybe needs to be a little, oops, I'm going to make that a little steeper, and let's see what happens. There we go. So just be conscious of the curves that you create for the speed forward in the Z, basically in this example, is going to have to match what happens with the rotation and how much or how fast or how slow it's rotating, right? When we get to this point here, this is where we're going to have to just do little keyframes to get it over that edge. You might even just go frame by frame. So if I select the Move tool, I'm going to kind of move it up a little bit so it appears to be on there. And I'll just go ahead and deselect both of those. Right. Right, because it's going to rotate off of that. This is where you're just going to be doing little observations. And obviously, once I get to this point with the roll, I can kind of do whatever I want. So let's go select the both of these so I can see where my keyframe is. In fact, actually, I can go to, let's do this. Let's go to my ball character set. You can see these are all the attributes. I haven't even started animating any of the squash and stretch, but now without selecting everything, I can see where those major keys are, right? In the bounce and everything. All right, so I started it rotating and it's coming down here. Let's look at that rotate. And I'm, from here, what I want it to do is kind of a constant rate as it comes off. So if I wanted to, I could just key selected and actually just move this straight up. I'm going to make it move like this, right? So it has a similar rate of rotation that it came off the pillar with, right? So once it hits, maybe we can do something totally different. So between here and here, let's just rotate it a whole bunch. You can see it's even moving at a faster speed. I'm going to keyframe all three of those just because of the way rotation gets calculated. So if I decide I need something even, frame here. So if I need something even more exaggerated, I can just do that in the graph editor, right? So it hits kind of linear, then as it hits again, maybe this time it just does just the almost like a little flop. Right? So it comes off, that speed seems pretty good. Now it's doing its own little rotation. Something different. And then we'll go to the new timing spot. And again, I'll key selected. Now we have a little hop, so now we're going to have to be a little more careful about where that happens. And from here, this is where you're going to have to do a little bit of guesswork, right? Figure that last little roll. And let's try this. Knowing that this is going to have to slow down at the end. You can see how it seems to be rotating even though it got to that final spot. So in that rotation there, I'm going to just hit flat. And let's frame in there so we can kind of see how that curve works, right? Again, I'm just kind of guessing on the rotation. But as I look at it, you know, as I was, we were animating before, it seemed clear where there was a little slippage going on in places. This seems to be holding, doing pretty well, I guess, right? So keeping in mind the rate of speed forward as it relates to the curve of the rotation, whether it's just going to be linear, in between the timing, we can decide on slightly different bounce rate or rotation rates, right? So let's see where we're at. There's so many little things I would want to fix with this. I think it needs to roll a little bit further and a little bit slower at that end. And maybe it rolls over here and then almost stops and then rolls back just a little bit to settle as if the floor is not quite even. That might be a nice little touch. But the basics are there, right? And it's a tutorial. That's what it's supposed to be. Hopefully yours is better than mine when you are done. All right. Hope that helps.